everyone. I'm Vanessa Chauhan, and I'm here with Shaw TV's Galas in Giving. We're here at the 7th Annual Charity Jam and Silent Auction in support of the Canadian Mental Health Association. The Canadian Mental Health Association, also known as the CMHA, kicked off Day 5 of Mental Health Awareness Week with the 7th Annual Charity Jam and Silent Auction, showcasing local talent and items donated from local businesses to help raise money for mental health programs. Emma Jones, fund developer for CMHA, gave us some insight on what goes on into planning such an event.
It's Mental Health Week across Canada, so it's a national education awareness campaign, and we're really trying to encourage people to hashtag get loud for mental health. So we have our local bands, the Veins playing, getting loud for mental health by talking about mental health to decrease the stigma.
Have you noticed any change in Canadian mental health awareness as far as after the fire?
You know, a lot of challenges in our organization on a staff level, on our volunteer facilitators. We don't necessarily have the same people in our organization now as we did.
Monica was affected by the recent wildfire and chose to find an outlet by volunteering to help others like she once needed.
One day I was looking for something to do because I didn't have anything to do and I was anxious, I was nervous, and I found that they were looking for volunteers the next day, and I met Emma, who's the events coordinator, and I went and met up with her for an event, just kind of bringing the awareness for the stigma of mental health, and I fell in love with it.
So pretty much you were able to volunteer and get through some of your anxieties by actually helping other people as well.
Yes, absolutely. No, and I think that's what drives me the most, is knowing that, you know, I'm not the only person in the world that feels like this, and that, you know, it's okay to not be okay, and it's just getting the right help and meeting the right people and doing things that make you feel better, and that's what makes me feel better, is the knowledge and learning about it and helping other people understand we're not alone.
RBC presented a check of $2,500 to aid in more programs and volunteer resources. Nancy Ball speaks highly of the CMHA and how it supports Teachers Association in schools.
You know, the mental wellness of our students and our colleagues and our community is very important to teachers. It's at the forefront of what we do. And we have known since the wildfire and returning to our community that the Canadian Mental Health Association is there beside us, and we know we can reach to them if we see families or students that need that extra support, and even colleagues.
With the Alberta Teachers Association looking to the future, the CMHA also realizes the need to have more accessible mental health programs for residents post-wildfire.
You know, due to the wildfires, we were all impacted. So there is more of that awareness, which is a little bit of that silver lining. However, I think now we need to do even more of an impact, more work, because not everyone's reaching out for support. They might have understanding about mental health, but what are the services available? So reaching out and seeking professional help if needed.
It's been a lovely evening here at the 7th Annual Charity Jam and Silent Auction. We've listened to some fantastic local talent in support of Canadian mental health. If you would like to get involved with the Canadian Mental Health Association, please visit their website down below. And if you would like us to cover your event, please contact Shaw TV and we'll be there.